Loose natural hair is not for women and men who work a 9-to-5. Stay tuned. All right, welcome to another episode of Clear Hair. But before you cancel me, let's play a quick game. Let's do oxymorons. So I have a list of oxymorons. You guys can put your own in the comments. I have jumbo shrimp, white chocolate, monogamy, and Nick Cannon. And I have straight hair natural. So today's episode, we are going to be discussing about the fact that loose natural hair is a thing of the past. A lot of the other trends too also include locks. People are locking up more. People are extending their protective hairstyles to life sentences, and people are also straightening their hair more often. So why? That's the main, like, whenever I make a video, I always do who, what, when, why, where, okay? Like a news report. So the question is why? Why are people switching to straight hair naturals? Well, let's talk about loose hair natural first. So loose hair natural, like, people are just like, these names are named up. So loose hair natural is basically when you wear your hair out, whether it's in an afro, a two-strand twist, or you're in an afro, a two-strand twist, or you were in a twist out. Like, loose natural is when you are wearing your hair out. Like, you're wearing your hair out. You don't have as much products in it. What else they consider loose hair natural? Which is, just sounds so crazy, because how your hair loose? It's a hair follicle. Sorry, too scientific. But that's basically what a loose hair natural is. And the first thing of the appeal of being a straight hair natural is, I'm tired of this, grandpa. So the appeal of being a straight hair natural is, number one, baby, like I said, during the day, accounting, at night and on the weekends, a content creator. So what I mean by that is, ain't nobody got time to do all those steps. Like, when they're just like, and then you deep condition, and then after you deep condition, you condition under water, and then you condition dry, and then you condition wet. I'm just like, oh my God, there's too many steps. By the time I'm done watching the tutorial, I'm just like, you know what? I'm just gonna put it in this bun. It's very expensive to be a loose hair natural. And what I mean by that is the products. And I know people are gonna say, and then we're gonna go, like I said, this is a court case today. We're gonna go for the case of the straight hair natural. But right now we're talking about loose hair naturals. It's expensive. I just realized, I went through my, and I'll do product care empties this month. And I went through my supplies. I need to go buy a $20 gel. Baby, do you know how much hair I have? I literally, this ponytail, I had to split this ponytail in half because that's how much hair I have. I have a lot of hair, and it's so densely packed back there. Okay, so when I sit there and I tell you, I have to buy this conditioner. So conditioner is $20, right? Boom. The gel's $25, the one that works, boom. Like, I already dropped $50. That's one brunch meal for the weekend. Okay, like, that's why I said, like, that's money. It's the labor. Like, I like it. You see the muscles? You see them? Like, I like the muscles that I got, I've given from doing hair for so long. But after working my day job, I just want to lay down for a little bit. I just want to lay down. It's not appealing to sit there and know after, like, after a long day's work, now you have to work some more. Like, one second. I don't want you guys to sit there and tell me, like, my name's literally Clear Hair. I'm not sitting there and I'm not telling you that, you know, with it being labor intensive, expensive, like, I'm not sitting there and telling you that, okay? I'm not telling you what to do, but I'm letting you know it's just not feasible in the morning to undo 50 twists before I go to work and drive an hour in the traffic. Like, it's not feasible, okay? I don't have the bandwidth to do it. So when I sit there and I see people going to the straight hair natural, I understand. So straight hair natural is some straight hair slash, I call them protective hair naturals. Basically, it's someone that you're not going to see that scalp. When it's protective hairstyle, you're not going to see that scalp as much, but mostly you're not going to see any type of curl pattern. I'm talking about our silk press season is every season. Winter, fall, spring, summer. Like every season is silk press season, or it's pressed out, or it's blew out, or it's flued out. Forget it, you know, or it's flued out. And there is this question of, are they really natural? And I feel like the term natural is without product. So that's why I'm going to go to my next point as well, is the fact that like being a straight hair natural, like let's go to the cons of that. So being a straight hair natural, there's damage. Okay. I call it curls integrity. So curls integrity is basically what curl pattern will you have? Because I did notice that when I would blow my hair out more, because like I said, like I just don't have time to sit here and air dry. I got stuff to do. I got places to be. When I used to sit there and have my hair air dry, I'm talking hours. I'm talking days. I'm talking like 5,000. Like literally, you're just waiting for your hair to dry. I'd rather watch paint dry. Don't tempt me. Paint drying is quicker. Like, I think it's like there are some cons, but the curl is the integrity is way, way better when you have way, way better when you're not putting as much heat on it. Like I said, it's time. Okay. Another thing too that's a pro of being a straight hair natural, a lot of hairstyles I'd be wanting to do. I don't even know if I could say this is my channel. This is my channel, so I'm gonna say it. But some of these hairstyles I'd be wanting to do, I was like, dang, that hairstyle would eat if my hair was straight. Dang, that ponytail would sit if my hair was straight. Or like, that was A, B, and C if my hair was straight. The main thing is the fact that like there's a lot of prospects of hairstyles that I want to do, but my hair is not straight and it's not going to sit for long. Because even with this hairstyle, like I purposely made sure, because I did these curls myself, I did the thing. I purposely made sure it was something similar to my hair texture. So when it starts getting fuzzy from me working out, I want it to be where it's still going to match compared to like, if this was like a silk, this was like straight bundles, then, if this was straight bundles, then like when it's time for me to work out, like it's already unmatching and then I get mad. So I get texture mad. But also like another con I would say too, to being straight hair natural is the fact that like, you know, you feel like you're kind of like taking the easy way out. Like it's kind of like when everybody sits there and says like, oh, I would never give my kid an iPad. You know, like it's kind of like you feel like you're taking the easy way out. You feel like you've given up on the natural hair community. You know, there's a lot of people and who like to confuse someone who got a texture release, which I'm just like, why are you saying Jerry curl like that? That's such a weird way to say Jerry curl. But when you see somebody get a texture release, I'm just like, now you know, that there's this thing as a texture release. It's basically, it's a texturizer. Like I, one thing I can say that Gen Z does a good job of doing, if it's one thing y'all Gen Zenians will do is y'all will remix a word and pretend we never heard of it. I was like, just like them samples y'all be using. Like we was there when it was first made. It's a texturizer. But definitely for sure. And then my final con for being a straight hair natural is the fact that you have to keep straightening it. Now, like I've told you guys before, I do live in the South and I can tell you straightening your hair is literally, I'm trying to think how to nicely say it. Like straightening your hair is literally a waste of time. I think that's the biggest thing I can say is like straightening your hair is a waste of time. I wouldn't see any reasoning to do it. Like you're going out the door and you're gonna wish you had never touched your hair. Like there's no reason in it. Like I don't know how to nicely say it. I don't think there's a nice way to say it, but like there's no reason to straighten your hair. Like once you get out the door, no more. And but like I said, like being a straight hair natural, I get it, you know? And then we can go into what makes you natural. So have a list down here of are you really natural? And the first thing we got to talk about our wig girlies. So basically, are you really natural? And that's basically our wig girlies. We're talking about people who, you know, they only let their hair breathe every solstice, every solstice. So only the winter and summer, they let their hair breathe twice a year, and their hair is healthy, it's moisturized. Like a lot of celebrities do this. I get it, because I feel like if you're messing with your hair consistently, there's not gonna be no hair to mess with. Like even me, like I'm not a celebrity, just saying, even with me, like I have a tendency where I'll take a break from like doing it really intense hairstyle. Like I'm already planning my hairstyle for March. So like there'll be a time where I'll just take a time off, because I feel like you keep messing with your hair, you're not gonna have no hair to mess with. But definitely our wig girlies, definitely our lace frontals, our half wigs, newly invited back sew-ins are making a way back. I thought we left them in 2009, but sew-ins are making their way back. But definitely for sure, like our wig naturals, and then our texture release. Technically, they're considered still natural because there's no extensions involved. But then again, like I said, what are the conditions to be considered natural? And then this one was kind of like a half and half. Like a lot of people don't consider you natural if that's not your natural hair color. So a lot of people who do like who color their natural hair, some people don't consider them natural, because technically that's not that. They think natural is like placenta perm, like what were you born with? That's what they consider natural. And then I also have the lock girly. Some people don't consider locks natural. And I was like, I don't know how much more natural you want to get, because having locks definitely for sure is natural. But definitely for sure, some people don't consider women who have locks natural. And that's why I said, like, that's why it's such a divisive topic to continue. Because at the end of the day, do what is good for your hair. Like, that's my solution for y'all, is do what's good for your hair. Me personally, like, when I was working from home predominantly, like it was easy for me to just have my hair just loose. Ain't nobody checking for me. Like no one's checking for me compared to now. Now I'm like in a hybrid situation where, you know, 2 days on, 2 days off. And 2 days on, 2 days off, where it's just like, dang, like when I get to work, like nobody got time to be wondering like what your hair gonna do. And that's the main thing. Like natural hair, as much as I love natural hair, like She is a temptuous beast. Like she literally picks when she wants to do stuff. Like I remember I had this cosplay. Y'all saw it. It was a cosplay for Photon, Monica Rambeau. And my hair didn't do what it was supposed to do. I was upset. Like it was supposed to be a big, big braid out. And my hair was like, I'm gonna shink today. Girl, like I don't have time to be in the middle of a presentation and one side of my hair is doing shrinkage, the other one is doing Aphrodite. Like I don't have time for it. Okay, I don't, and I shall not be judged for it. I shall not be judged for not having my hair out. But it's true. Like you literally get to the point where like you're just so frustrated. And if being a straight hair natural is easy for you, do it. You know, do that. If being a straight hair natural is easier for you, do it. If being a protective style girl is better for you, do it. If a wig, sew-in, colored, locks, whatever you want to do, do it. Because at the end of the day, you got to do your hair. So don't forget to subscribe, share. It's clear.